it's Craig. Craig Stevie. Starting my horizontal hive project. I'm going to build four of everything. I'm going to assemble three of them. Keep the fourth one as a pattern for future builds. If you haven't seen a horizontal hive, it's that pinkish purplish looking long hive. Instead of building them vertically, we build them horizontally. It's just a different way of doing it. It's a whole lot easier on your back because you're not picking up heavy boxes all the time. And there's a lot of people in Europe that use them. And so it's one of those things that I want to try. And I'm going to build one of the three for me. I got a couple other people want them. And just kind of just go for it and see what we think about them. I feel like my horizontal hive has like all the features of every horizontal hive out there. All added into one. So I've kind of taken some patterns from the internet, from YouTube and stuff like that, and just watched a bunch of information about what people are doing and what they're using, and incorporated most of that stuff into it. So it's able to be insulated, it's able to be ventilated. So summer, winter, it doesn't matter when it is, it's gonna work really well. So I'm gonna just start cutting out wood right now and just start building the main box assembly. And then we'll go from there. Trim off the end, make sure you get a nice square edge to start with, and then go from there. All right, so if you're wondering what just happened, I didn't have my saw locked down and the angle turned a little bit on me. So I lost about 1/8 of an inch, 1/4 of an inch on each end. But I hadn't cut the end pieces anyway, which are about half of, just under half of the length of the width of the length of the book, the beehive. So the good news is I didn't waste any wood hardly at all, because all I had to do is square up both ends, measure it and cut it. So that's good. But I gotta check all these. That one closed right up on me. The hole just closed right up on the blade. It's not good. I'm gonna do this a little smarter. I noticed on that cut that it's getting a lot of dust. This thing's full already. I'm gonna dump it. All right, where we go. Come on, camera, follow me around. So what just happened again was this thing closed in on me as soon as I started cutting it, started crimping down on the blade. So I pulled back out and just went back in again because the centerpiece is a scrap piece anyway. So I just went back out and put that through again. Still on my mark and everything was fine. The other trick is get past any cracks or whatever on the ends. Get them out of there too. Square up the board and get rid of the ends, the cracked ends. By the way, if you're paying attention to what I'm doing, you see anything that I'm doing wrong, because I'm not a woodworker, just like I'm not a welder, feel free to let me know, because I like to learn. I want to do it the right way. So. Fly Racing, nothing but the best. Can tell this board was either the top or the bottom one, because it has staples all over the sides of it. That's where they put all their notes of what this stuff is. All right, so all right, so we're done with that.